that'll help slightly.
Certainly possible. Would require strengthening exercises. Get muscles to support weaker bone structure.
Right. Yeah, I can do that.
Alloy of Edie's body not flexible like organic tissue could cause unintentional damage. Recommend pillows, cushions, possibly gel packs.
Okay, that's a little weirder, but yeah, all right, cushions.
Positioning critical to success. Can forward Edie charts, videos with relevant data.
No, Edie's pretty busy with, you know, stuff. Let's just send that to me. You're not gonna tell anyone about this, right? Like Shepard? Shepard doesn't really need to know.
Guarantee Shepard won't learn about it from me.
She's standing right there, isn't she?
I wish I wasn't.
Is he talking about Edie? Cushions? Are they talking about their sex life or impending sex life?
Shepard, Eve ready for travel to Tuchanka.
Nice talking with you, Morden.
We'll be here if you need me. Continuing to study Shroud in meantime.
Okay. Gonna talk about the Prothean.
Something else, Commander?
Thanks for talking to me.
It's my pleasure, Commander.
Just sped that up a little bit. All right. Yeah, so we're headed back up to, well, I call it the bridge. I'm sure she'll have something to say about the Prothean.
Those poor colonists on Eden Prime. First the Geth attack, now Cerberus. For what it's worth, our new crew member doesn't need a translator himself, but he shared a Prothean language tutorial program.
Okay.
It's apparently designed for servant races being inducted into the Empire.
Oh.
Charming cultural clue.
Okay.
Commander?
Now, I already read emails, so I don't know why I did that. Let's check in on Joker and Edie and what they're doing with, cushions.
Alright, here's another one. Dates back to the Rachni Wars. So, a Krogan and a Salarian have landed on a Rachni world for a top secret mission.
That is unlikely. Salarians rarely took part in raids on Rachni occupied worlds directly.
Missing the point? So the two guys are climbing up a hill going through this nasty green fog. And as they get near the top, they come out of the fog and the Salarian sees thousands of Rachni. He looks over at the Krogan and says, "Oh, well, that makes me nervous!" The Krogan says, "You think that's scary? When this is over, I have to go back down through that fog by myself."
The implication being that the Salarian soldier would be dead.
Yes.
Right.
Thank you for killing the 2,000-year-old joke.
That joke plays to racial stereotypes on both sides. The Krogan appears brutish and insensitive, while the Salarian appears weak.
Nice.
Stereotypes such as exemplified here led to the development and use of the genophage.
Oops.
Well, yeah. It's also one of the only jokes you'll hear both Salarians and Krogan telling. Comedy isn't really about being nice. Sometimes it's a way to air out the ugly things people think.
Hmm. Well, I'll leave it to Joker to give a tutorial on comedy.
So a Prothean, a real-life Prothean, hasn't the R stopped bouncing yet? I'm guessing there may have been some bouncing.
Not exactly, but that would have been adorable.
Commander?
How's our new visitor adjusting to the ship, Edie?
He appears not to understand the human custom of separate sex restroom facilities.
Huh.
I am attempting to enlighten him. I will update you if there is positive progress.
How about you just update me if he doesn't get the message?
Very well.
Although luckily I have my own restroom, so I'm safe.
Hello, Shepard.
I miss all the idle chatter when we run down the, you know, whatever this place is. I had an option. Thank you. Alright, so heading back down.
We could be on the front lines. Why have they got us guarding the door anyway? He's gonna break regs right now.
War makes people stupid. Besides, you talked to Monroe? Electors invaded this ship and kidnapped the crew.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I guess we gotta be ready for anything to come through that door.
Yeah, that was a pretty fun part of the last story. Please let me through. Thank you. Keep wondering if this place is going to be built into something more. So Rex is here somewhere. He usually stands here. Neither of them are here. What the hell? Although the map shows them being here. Well, I guess we're gonna go over our war assets. Terminus Fleet. The Terminus Fleet is an assortment of mercenary vessels and pirate ships bound together by little more than a common geography and a fear of the Reapers. Despite this volatile mix, the fleet seems to be functioning as one under the leadership of criminal warlord Arya Taloke. Yeah, read this, right? This private security group is careful to maintain its image as a professional mercenary force. In reality, the Blue Suns have drifted further and further into becoming a full-blown crime syndicate. Despite this, their ruthless tactics are sought after in the Terminus systems. Updated. The Eclipse Corporation specializes in smart security solutions, developing tactics around surgical strikes, sabotage, and electronic warfare. These mercenaries are supported by a sizable army of combat mechs and rely heavily on tech for support in combat. Governor Grothan Pazness. Oh, cool. The governor of the Batarian colony, Kamala, was outspoken in the early hours of the Reaper assault, blaming the Alliance for the destruction of Batarian comm buoys that were, in fact, destroyed by the Reapers. Now liberated from his world, the governor has undergone a dramatic conversion. His daily extranet videos rally his formerly conservative, xenophobic subjects to embrace the Citadel species as brothers and sisters in arms. Unlike many Presbyterian politicians, he also avoids micromanaging military affairs, content with inspirational tasks and the logistical nightmare, of providing urgently needed relief to Batarian refugees. Just gonna take a drink. Void Devil's Fighter Wing. The Void Devils are a recent military creation consisting of Vorcha fighter pilots trained by human and Turian mentors. Though uniformly young by other species standards, the Devils have laser-like focus on the task of taking out enemy ships. Courageous in the extreme, they are also notably disciplined for Vorcha. During the invasion of their homeworld, the Devils fought hard but ultimately obeyed the order to retreat while the wing was still intact, leaving them alive but burning for revenge. Vorcha Labor Team. Goggles. These socialized Vorcha were a maintenance and calibration crew on a small scientific outpost orbiting Tyrix. Such skilled labor is rare among Vorcha but not unheard of, since Vorcha trained by other species for precision tasks develop finely tuned nerves and senses. Additionally, this crew can heal cellular damage caused by radiation exposure, which is useful since the Crucible is being built where no planet's magnetosphere protects it, and extravehicular activity on its hull is often required. Alliance. Arcturus 1st Division. The Arcturus 1st Division is a volunteer army of civilians, paramilitary forces, and reserve soldiers who have banded together to stop the Reaper occupation of the planet Benning. To avoid detection by Reaper forces, its members operate in cells, never staying in one place long. A handful of Alliance officers are coordinating the 1st Division, sharing intel and sending supplies to the Resistance soldiers. A few Alliance squadrons have been spared to support Benning's makeshift army with trained soldiers. Alliance cruiser Shanghai. Yeah, some of the stuff we just found. Like right before landing on Eden Prime. The Shanghai is most... You know, I was kind of hoping we would travel through Eden Prime some more. All we did was run through some buildings and that's it. Anyway, hold on a second. The Shanghai's most important part in the Reaper War to date was the evacuation of the colony Ukbar. Alliance intel reported Reaper forces headed toward Ukbar, but as a cruiser, the Shanghai was unable to land on the medium gravity world. The Shanghai's captain quickly dispatched all its shuttles to help transport hundreds of colonists onto the ship. Making over 41 shuttle runs in a single hour, the Shanghai managed to evacuate the entire remaining population. When Reaper forces arrived, Ukbar's capital city was as empty as if it had never been inhabited at all. Alliance Naval Exploration Flotilla. In peacetime, the Alliance's Naval Exploration Flotilla is used as a survey force to chart out new systems. The NEF came under fire in 2185 when several dozen service people were charged with withholding information on rich mining deposits in order to sell the locations to the exploration firm Barrier Frontiers. The Alliance attempted to hide the controversy to little avail as more and more officers were indicted. Eager to bury its shady history, the NEF has dedicated its entire flotilla and material resources to constructing the Crucible. Rogue fighter pilots. That's an Eden Prime support. When humanity began to expand its borders, experienced pilots were needed to establish colonies in the uncharted reaches of space. Some Alliance personnel heeded the call, and these luckless men and women have since been driven out of their colonies by the invading Reapers. After speaking with Lieutenant Steve Cortez, a few of these highly skilled fighter pilots agreed to fly against the enemies who destroyed their homes. Eden Prime support. Eden Prime is an agrarian world, producing millions of tons of food that is sold to less arable planets. The Alliance has set up supply lines from this colony to funnel excess provisions to its troops. Updated. A few researchers who studied Prothean technology on Eden Prime avoided capture by Cerberus. They forwarded copies of their work to the Alliance, hoping it can help build the Prothean device found on Mars. Updated. Although its military defenses were seriously damaged by the Cerberus invasion, Eden Prime's remaining government has loaned the Alliance several Athabasca-class supply freighters. Updated. Eden Prime's colonists drove Cerberus away from their system entirely. With its shipping lanes secure, the colony is sending out as many supplies and equipment as it can spare. Good to hear. That's because we found all that info that Liara was able to transmit to them. Crucible. Okay, we've read about the Javelin missile launchers. Prothean data files. These Prothean disks were found years ago on Eden Prime, recovered a few months before the discovery of the Prothean beacon in 2183. For years, the data on the disks was incomprehensible, until the Crucible's blueprints provided the key to understanding the equations. Locked inside the disks were theories on dark matter meant to be used with the Crucible's main power source. Optimized ESO capacitors. A team of engineers working on the Normandy SR-2 developed the theory behind this piece of equipment. Dreadnought class drive capacitors uses specialized ESO-based compounds to channel and store thermal energy with greater efficiency than previous designs. These capacitors were quickly incorporated into the design of the device found in the Prothean archives on Mars. Cool. We could look at the map, but... always 50% on everything. Okay. Still so weird that these guys are not here, even though the map shows them as being here. And if they aren't here, then where the hell are they? Strange, huh? Definitely not here. Not invisible. Unless he's also intangible.
Commander Shepard.
That's me. So I want to take a quick look at these quests here. We don't have anything as far as this, otherwise it'd be flashing, obviously. We're pretty low on quests, I like it. Tuchanka, that's on Tuchanka. This is Leviathan DLC. This, I've yet to find. This is Tuchanka, and these two are somewhere in the galaxy. So, I'm thinking for the next couple episodes... I'm surprised, actually, this DLC was so short. Oh, you know what? Let's hit the mass relay and go back to Asgard. I'm gonna go here to the Horsehead Nebula and fuel up. There are two more assets in the Asgard system. And we can get there and back with a full tank of fuel. Where is it again? I don't remember where I came from. It is Reaper occupied, isn't it? Nidma cluster, Gemini. It's the Exos cluster right here. Oh, we're so close to it. Okay, so we found all the assets here in Utopia, so let's go to Asgard. Now, my notes actually referred back to my first episode coming in. Well, last episode I was in here anyway. We've scanned this area. We found two things. And we've actually scanned the first three planets. We have not scanned near this planet. Oh, crap. It was down low and then it went so high up. Let's see what we find here. Cool. Probe launched. Alliance Spec Ops Team Delta. Cool. Percent. Now we need to find one more thing. I'm just going to listen to that sound, because I'm pretty sure we got all the planets. We're listening for that boop. Thought I heard it's kind of low there. Trying to be really thorough and systematic here in my search. Because the next scan will bring the Reapers here, so I really have to... We were over here, though. Where the hell is it? And I can't come back here until... We can't clear out the Reaper status until we do another mission. Until we finish another mission. You know, I'm not completely sure we hit this planet. Let's try it. We can exit out that way. Nope.
Reapers we're out.
We got one more. Oh, I hate it. I'm gonna have to come back here. Such a pain because you scan twice and they're in. It's back here again. I'm gonna visit two more systems actually. Just fill out some time here. All full, yay, all full of num nums fuel. Alright. In the Arcturus stream, we have one asset in Arcturus. We haven't scanned, I guess, this planet. 50% recovered. Stop increasing. I said I wrote down I hadn't scanned the gas giant. I don't know which gas giant I mean. What? I hear it. units of fuel. 100% done. Now next is Kite's Nest. I don't think there is a fuel station there, so to come back here again. I want to find everything that there is to find. I'm already full on fuel. That's right, I didn't have to leave the system. Duh. Okay. Never mind. Kite's Nest. We have Indris and Vular systems. Engage. Okay, Harsa, we've fix that one. Indris is this way. Indris, we've scanned all but the outermost planet. All but the outermost planet is scanned. Which would be... Where is that way? Oh, all the way up here. Ooh, I heard that. It's not on a planet. 300 units of fuel. Well, we're just gonna find fuel. Well, it helps us get to the next one. which is Vular. Here as well. Did I just hear a sound? No. Vular. I forgot to read the gas giant. It's something else. It's more fuel or something. Interesting that this theme has stayed the same throughout all three games. I love it. Quite a journey, right? From the first game to this one. Trying to find it. It'll be complete with this system, this whole cluster. I'm glad I didn't use up gas doing this. Oh, damn it, where are you? I gotta find it. Travel along all these. Sorry guys, I just really want to find this. Oh, this is so frustrating. Where are you? Wait, that was a planet. Thought I found it. Well, I scanned the planets. Let me just try here. Nope. Wait. Fuel. No. Eat.
Faster than light jump successful.
Sorry, guys. I have my hand on my mouth. I did it. Okay. Yay. Oh my god, it was so close. So glad I did it. Let's get the hell out of here. Let's go back here. Safe system. Cluster, whatever. So we can use a little fuel. Oof. Anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. The only outstanding one then is in the Asgard system. We found one missing one. After the next mission, I might just have to go back there and use that same technique. Just rapidly scan all over the frickin' place. And hopefully we'll find what we are looking for. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.